G'day, ZiggyD here, and welcome back for some more Borderlands, the pre-sequel. In this video, I have for you guys another boss farming series. You guys really enjoyed my 40-minute farming video for Iwajura, and tonight, we're going to be doing some other really fun runs. This is possibly my most favorite run in Borderlands pre-sequel, and it is Red and Belly runs. So, Red and Belly are located here in Crassus Scar. There we go, I was moused over the wrong one. And these runs are very snappy, very fun. They have a lot of interesting kind of fun jumps to doing them to actually get to the boss. There's a little shortcuts and things you can take. The boss fight is actually pretty fast and fun. And the legendary weapon that they drop is pretty cool as well. So, what we're going to be hoping to get tonight is a striker. But Ziggy, you already have a striker. That's right, I did like 20, 30 runs of Red and Belly over the past, I don't know, week or so. And in that time, I did manage to finally get myself a striker, which is this fantastic, very high crit damage, very accurate shotgun here. This thing has a very tight grouping of pellets, and if you get a headshot with this thing, which is very easy to do as Nisha, you do insane amounts of damage. However, I finally got it, but it's level 49. Bum, bum, bum. So bosses in this game have a chance of dropping, level 50 bosses have a chance of dropping like a level lower than them sometimes. So when that happens, you basically get scammed. And I managed to get the striker, but it is 49, which just, oh, it's painful because although this is good and effective and we can even use it on these runs, it's not perfect. It could be so much better. You know, we're going to get a nice extra chunk of damage if I get a perfect one. And because I want to actually make builds around this weapon, because I love this shotgun on Nisha, I want to get the perfect one, guys. I want to get it. So, that's what we're going to be trying to do. We may or may not get lucky. The drop chance on this thing seems to be pretty moderate to low, so we may or may not get lucky, but I think we'll have a bit of fun at least. And as with the Iwajura video, I'll edit it down just to the fun parts for you guys, and you guys can sort of see what it's like to do a massive farming session, all condensed down into, you know, just a 30-40 minute video for you guys to enjoy. So, let's get on with it! I will be using the 88 Fragnum that I crafted earlier. This is a level 50 88 Fragnum. Intense with Loonshide. Chance to ignore enemy shields. Pretty nice weapon. Pretty nice weapon. A bit hard to hit with Torg weapons. I struggle with Torg weapons. I'm not very good with them. It's not the perfect Fragnum, though. It's intense. The best prefix for Fragnum is probably a double one. It essentially doubles the damage. So, not the best we could have gotten, but still a really good weapon. I also have the Excalibur, though I probably won't be using this for these runs, actually. What I will be using, though, is the most optimal weapon for these runs, and that is a fire beam laser, at least with Nisha. But if you can get a fire weapon for these runs, you're going to do a lot better. So, I'm going to be using this. It's just a purple Mercury Beam Malawan laser, but it's got really good damage, really good damage bonus. It's got the Loonshine enchantment, which doesn't really matter, but the fact that it's a fire weapon is going to be really effective, and you guys will see soon why. We have Miss Moxie's Vibra Pulse we can use to heal ourselves. It's another beam weapon, and of course we have the crappy striker that we'll hopefully upgrade. Otherwise, I just have some purples, nothing really fancy here. This Desperado class mod is very nice, though. Bottled Courage, Ruthless Skill, High Noon, and then we've got Rubberized Stormfront, which is just kind of this electric grenade that I usually use to wipe out people's shields. So, once you get to Crassus Scar, you'll spawn here in the fast travel station, but you don't want to be a scrub. You don't want to do the scrub runs of Red and Belly. The scrub runs are to run from the fast travel and go kill Red and Belly. You guys don't want to do that. You guys want to do the fast, efficient runs. So what we're going to do first is change our spawn zone so that we spawn much, much closer to the boss. So I'm going to run here, trying to avoid these cryo plants, and just avoiding all those mobs there. There's some mobs there, you can kill them if you're leveling up. You can do Red and Belly runs to level up at the lower levels, and maybe get a, you know, a striker to level with. You also get some, you know, skin customizations and things like that. So you can do those at a lower level, and it's decent XP as well. You get to kill a few mobs along the way, and the boss itself gives decent XP. But it's also probably one of my favorite endgame farming runs as well. Alright, we're going to run down here, grab a little bit of O2, we're going to hook over to the right here. Then don't run next to the cryoplants, because what happens is they'll freeze you and you will not make the jump. I'm stuck on a wall. So you want to jump from here, not the cryoplant. Even though it looks like a pretty far jump, you will make it. I'm going to slam down here. And then what we're going to do, instead of going off to the left to go fight Red and Belly, we're actually going to head over to the right to this doorway. So what happens is, after you do the Red and Belly mission, you will head out this way afterwards to, you know, continue on your merry way on your questing. And you'll leave through this door. But once you've done the Red and Belly quest, and this is important for all boss farming, is to make sure you've actually finished and handed in the quest. So fully finish the quest if you want to do some Red and Belly farming. But we've obviously finished since I'm level 50. We're going to head through that door and come back. I'm I think you do need to go through the door. I'm not 100% sure. You might need to go near it, but going through the door definitely sets it. So now our respawn point when we save and log in is going to be this zone right here. So I think I am. I think I'm all loaded up. I think my weapons are loaded. Yeah, we do this. All right, we'll start off with the beam laser, and I'll try and show you guys a perfect run on the first go. Let's give it a shot. So we're gonna run here. I recommend killing these guys. So I'm just gonna beam laser these guys down really quickly with Nisha's aimbot ability. And this is one way of doing it: jumping up to here, slamming down, jumping across to this wall. You don't want to run through the doorway like a scrub. You want to do this fast and efficient. We're gonna boost across to here. I'm gonna try and land just on the right of that pole. Uh-oh, not quite right. Not quite right. And then we're gonna jump and boost and try and land on this light. Oh wow, I did it. Now we're gonna jump onto that sign. Yes, perfect. And then we're gonna jump over here. Now what we're gonna do just here is laser this little box here. Run around here, we're gonna boost over the top here, be nice and fast. And this is refined over the course of like, I don't know, 50 runs or something like that. And I figured out kind of the fastest way to do this run with a bit of help from some viewers that were doing it as well. You can grab any loot you want in here, or if you need any ammo refills, you're gonna get them there. Then what you want to do is jump inside here. You'll get any O2, so you don't need to worry about that. You can check each of these vendors in case they're spawned with a legendary, so or if you need any other gear upgrades, or you can sell any gear that you've gotten from previous runs in here as well. And then this fight can actually be pretty difficult. Even when I just scaled it up to 50, because they're level 52 and they are pretty nasty, this fight can be pretty difficult if done wrong. So I'm going to try and show you guys the right way to do it without me dying, and then and then I'll explain it maybe on future runs. But alright, let's do concentration mode. Oh wait, I failed, I forgot. Okay, so for that first section, because they're armored up and you're not able to hit the fleshy part, it's better just to use a physical or explosive weapon. So that worked him down really quickly. Gonna burn off this ad just here. You can leave the ads alive to spawn off if you want. Alright, and we should have our boost back up now. And what we want to do is, with Nisha, you want to get above belly and shoot him from the top, because then you'll get him with headshots from the beam laser, and you'll burn his head. So the reason we're using his fire is because these guys are fleshy targets. I kind of screwed up and I didn't get the crits, so I'm just going to wait. I'm going to like just wait a moment here. Alright, we're ready. Alright, there we go. There's the crits, and then you'll burn him down very fast. And then red, you want to actually get underneath him, since he's a flying target, it's not too hard, and shoot him in the legs, because that's where his crit point is. So for belly, you want to shoot him in the head, and for red, you want to shoot him in the legs. And with a fire weapon, you're going to do a ton of damage. So as you can see, lots of skin customizations dropping. We've got a blue SMG we can sell there. I'll try and let you guys know like how much cash we've got. So we're starting at 1.6 million. We'll see where we end up, and 335 moonstones. So you guys can keep track of that if you want, and we'll see how much we end up making. But we'll end up getting the loot here. I'm only going to pick up blues and above to sell. And then we've got a moonstone here. We've got another skin. Now, I haven't seen anything dropped. We got a troll striker. That's not a striker. That is not a striker. But it looks like I don't see anything there. I don't see any shotguns or anything like that. So what we're going to do then is come up the stairs here, and there's an open doorway. And there's another treasure chest in here. There's so much loot from this run, guys. This run is fantastic. As I said, one of my favorite runs, because it's fun to do. It's fast. There's lots of loot here. I think I just accidentally equipped some shitty thing. Oh, I did. All right, let's equip our legendary grenade again. Now we're going to run up here. Now, if you've saved up some moonstones from Iridura farming or something, you can spend them here. And since I like to make these videos entertaining for you guys, I'm going to do some moonstone gambling. So let's see what we get. Now, you can get legendaries from these, and they can be Loonshine enchanted. You can also get other nice Loonshine enchantments. What do we get? I got a TDR, no Loonshine enchantment, we'll sell that. And we got a Vladoff with less O2 consumption. It's a fire Vladoff. It's not too bad, actually, but it's only a blue. I'd probably, if it was a purple and a bit higher damage, I'd probably use that. But otherwise, we'll just pop this stuff here. And then we're going to head upstairs. Now, let me see. I've actually kind of forgotten where this last thing is. No, I think I can remember. There's one last loot chest on this run before we log out. And if we just scoot up this way, we should be able to just grab it and then log straight back out. There we go, there's the final loot chest. And perfect, we got a rocket launcher, that's fine, I'm just gonna log out here. Alrighty, let's do the next run. So that's kind of the breakdown. Now I'm gonna try and explain the actual run process a little bit more. And we'll try and do a slightly more efficient run as well, because there is a slightly better run you can do, at least for this first part. Everything else I did pretty well. I'm surprised, honestly. I am surprised. Because I tend to screw these up. So what we're going to do is we're going to run it just to about here. Going to laser these guys real quick before they get a chance to spread around. Then we're going to run and jump on this truck. Run and jump on this roof. and then run and jump on here. Now, I think this is faster than jumping on that little silo, and there's less room for error. So we're going to get it perfect, right to the left of here. Perfect. Uh-oh, I kind of screwed up the running a little bit, but we can do it. We made it. We made it. Oh, I don't think I'm getting another sign. Oh, close. We got on the sign. Oh, man, I'm doing so well tonight. I'm honestly shocked, guys. I am honestly shocked. If you guys were watching my stream, then you've probably seen me do some red and billy runs in the past, and the immense amount of scrubs and the times I forgot the chests and all these sorts of other things. It was real, guys. It was real. Alright, let's grab this ammo just here. So we're saving cash by not having to buy ammo over again. Oh, man, laser ammo especially can get so expensive. So, yes! 3DD1.E. Now, this is awesome because this is actually a very hard Oz kit to get. I believe this drops from the Claplek, the Dalek claptrack from one of the side quests, and he's not a farmable boss, I don't believe. I think he only spawns once and you have to Alt F4 farm him. But the fact we got it from a vendor means I don't even need to worry about that. So that is awesome. So this thing has like a little AI and everything, and it does like random stuff for you. Experiment sentient AI module. Occasionally performs repairs on your shield and life support systems during combat, and sometimes drops a care package when you kill enemies. Very protective of its owner. I want it! I want it! Oh. Finally, we got a good air kit. I've been using this just like random purple one for ages. It had weapon accuracy and Oz and crit damage while airborne, which was nice for these fights. But I want to try this thing, 3DD1. Beep boop beep. So apparently it talks to you. I'll be interested to see, you know, how it talks to us and stuff. So, not screwing up this time, switching to my pistol. So you want either fizz, just some sort of fizz weapon for this first part. Alright, and then you can burst them down for this first part. Once they get to 75%, they then go to the center of the area and, you know, separate, essentially. So we can switch to our fire weapon just here. This has done pretty well so far. We can kill this guy just here before this thing starts. And they're starting up. I want to get airborne and go. Alright, I kind of didn't get airborne so well. Maybe I can kill him in the one go. Maybe I can kill him. Oh, wow. Yes, perfect. There you go, guys. That's the perfect kill right there. We got some moonstone. What else do we score here? Nothing, nothing. Some skins and stuff. I already got more moonstone. I see a blue grenade I can sell. There is a scav there. I should have picked up that rocket launcher. They're actually pretty good money for the amount of space they take up. Ah, and here we go. We got Red Belly's Black Snake. So, this is a unique drop from the head, Red. And he's... It's not too bad as far as it goes. It's always corrosive, and it you know, it's a submachine gun with decent fire rate and damage. So it's not too bad if you're doing some farming of different like robots, or if you're doing some RK5 farming and you do well with submachine guns. It's not too bad. So you can get this as many times as you want. It's also a pretty common drop. It drops fairly frequently. But this brings up an interesting point, is that Red the Head drops Red Belly's Black Snake, right? And he doesn't actually drop the other legendary, but who will drop the legendary is Belly. Belly does drop the Flacker legendary, whereas this guy's kind of boss drop is this particular unique here. So you can get these if you want. You can take these and sell them if you want, or you can you know, try and find the best rolled one you can to use if you ever need a corrosive weapon. I think I already have one. I'm not sure. I don't really care about it too much because I know I can always come back and get one pretty easily, and because I like these runs, it's not much of a hassle. Alrighty, nothing in there. Well, I'm full, so I can't take it. I better actually sell some things, but let's check out the moonstone. Maybe I should dump some stuff before we do the moonstone chest. Let me dump some blues here. Like, alright, what do we get? Oh, we got some pistols. Purple pistols. Ooh, Malawan corrosive. We got a Jacob's purple there. Ooh, the damage on that's pretty high. O2 consumption. What is on this one back here? That's a scav pistol with 30% chance to ignore enemy shields. It's a double, too. Ooh, that's not a bad scav pistol. Too bad I don't like scav pistols. I'm gonna take the purples and sell them. But, nothing I'm gonna really use here. Let's go up to the final chest. Check it out. Alright, just a rocket launcher. Alright, let's do the next run. I'm gonna try something new here. See if this works. Maybe if I electrocute these guys, they'll die, and I can just do this run without worrying about them. Save a bit of time. They're still shooting at me. I've been killed in the air while jumping before, so I get a bit paranoid and I kill those guys. I think I might have actually got the kill with the grenade. That's pretty good. Let's see if we can make the jump. Oh, man, I'm getting good at this. Wow, yes. Oh, all right, I take it back. I take it back. I knew I had to screw up sooner or later. That failed jump. I, like, fell off and then boosted. Yes, good. Awesome. So I used to, like, I love all the, like, little refine. You guys kind of haven't seen the process of refinements we've made, but I used to, like, jump over to the bridge and then run around and then jump over there. But, got it all worked out. There might be some further refinements to make, but I like this. It kind of makes me want to speedrun this game. I don't know. I might want to at some point. Because, this game's pretty fun to, like, run and jump around in. And that's kind of, like, what speedrunning is about. Is, like, figuring out those most efficient routes and, you know, nailing those jumps perfectly. I might be into that. I don't know. What do you guys think? Would you like to see some sort of, like, you know, amateur speedrunning content? Because I'm obviously not very good. But, let's see. I got 1 million because I bought that legendary. 1 million and 20. Let's sell this stuff and see how much we end up with. There we go, 1.4 million just from that load, so I think we're going to work up our cash pretty quickly. Alright, let's kill Red and Belly. Oh, no pistols. Oh, he's far away this time, this could be awkward. That might be a little bit awkward. Whoa, taking a lot of damage. I got this new shield recently that's made this a lot easier, but I used to get absolutely wrecked in this fight. So, we're doing pretty well now, but man, I hope we get that flacker tonight, that'll be fantastic if we do. Oh boy. Not the best start. There's the headshots. Gotta do the aim down sight. Uh-oh. It's not going well. Alright, we got Belly down. Ooh, I see some shinies. I wonder what it's gonna be. I didn't think I saw a golden beam. I saw lots of moonstone, though. Be interested to see how long I can keep my moonstone up. I'm obviously gonna be spending more moonstone than I make on this run. This is a good way to blow your moonstone this particular run. Because of the, There's the crits. As soon as you get those crits, you just absolutely destroy them. Yeah, because of those moonstone chests, you end up spending way more than you make in terms of this run. But you do get a chance at some pretty cool loot, and I do like gambling on those things. Oh, what do we got here? Okay, now let's pick up this stuff first. I got a shotgun, I got some random stuff, got some moonstone. Let's kill these guys real quickly so they don't annoy us. Because this thing right here is the ultimate troll. I'll show you guys. So this is a purple head, right? I've obviously already got this. But what this means, if this head drops, it means he stole your legendary. This head right here, this little jerk, he ate your legendary. What an asshole. Now, the reason for that is bosses have a loot drop slot that they can... Oh, there's my shield is throwing out little things for me. So they have a loot drop slot where they can drop a legendary or a head customization. And that's what... That chewed up his loot drop slot. So he dropped the head instead of the legendary. So, that sucks. You're bastard. Alright, let's finish the rest of the run. Oh, I forgot something. I've been forgetting this all the run so far. If you just run in and punch this thing, you can get a bunch of cash. So it's pretty fast to do. You just like run in and punch that thing and get cash. Sometimes items even spawn in there, like a pistol or something as well. I'll take the rocket launch just to sell, because they sell for pretty good cash. 20k per, even if it's only a green. And then a lot more if it rolls like blue or purple. What do we got? We got 4 purple grenades. Now, this kind of sucks as a moonstone chest to drop because grenades and other mods can't roll moonstone properties. So, loonshine properties. So, that's just cash. We just basically converted moonstone to cash at a very inefficient rate. Oh, well. Go, little bouncing rubberized grenade. What a boss. Look at him. Check him out. Absolutely beasting it. Let's see if we get the kills. I did, because my little Oz kit spawned the whatever that little thing is that it spawns. I haven't heard the Oz kit talk yet, though. It's supposed to talk. I heard it was talking. I guess we haven't had... Oh, man. That's twice in a row. Oh, boy. Yeah, I haven't heard the Oz kit talk yet. I guess it hasn't had a reason to talk yet. Here we go. There's some pretty awkward spots it can spawn in. That one's a pretty good one, though, right in the middle there. If he spawns kind of like to the left behind one of the pillars, it can be a bit of a problem. And I've activated my ability, and then just like not seeing them before. Like, wow, okay. I thought I got him down to his 75%. Apparently not. No, he needed to take like one more damage. Okay, well that's not the smoothest boss fight ever. It's alright, we didn't actually die. Here we go. No, I didn't want to kill Red first. Well, we're gonna kill Red first apparently. Wasn't getting the crits, that's a very slow kill. Ah, this one has been a mess all round. Let me switch to my pistol here. Unleash some damage with the fragnums. Oh damn, the fragnums are sick, aren't they? Especially once I've got those unchained stacks. I've got 20 stacks of unchained up at the moment. Look at the fire rate. I just unload those clips. And I've got extra clip size as well from the skill tree. Not as fast as the laser, because the laser is fire and they're weak to fire and you get the crits with the headshots really easy. Oh, man. It's the head again. Oh, well. What else do we get? Blue doll. Soul rifle there. And... great. Great. I just killed the ad as I died. Fantastic. That's awesome. Well, rip in pepperoni's cash. I guess we won't be doing the chests on this run. Oh man. Oh, and I missed a moon. I can see like a big moonstone cluster there at the same time as well. Just rubbing it in my face, my death. Let's see how much cash we lose. Losing cash, when you got like this much cash, dying is like a bit painful. How much cash do I lose? Oh my god. Oh, we actually respawned here. I will go do the chests then. Look at that. 10,000,001. Just that extra troll $1 at the end there. Yay, but we got 1,900 cash back. It's gonna make up for it. We'll make the money back in no time, don't worry. Moonstoney Moonstone, what do you got for me? Oh, I see something big. We have sniper rifle. A Malawan fire sniper rifle. Well, I'm not really interested in sniping. I'll take those to sell, I guess. Lawbringer. Unchained tombstone. +6 unchained. Wow, I've never seen +6 before. That's ridiculous. You can get up to 11 on skills. Wow, that's pretty cool. I'm gonna take that. All right, let's do a run with our level 49 strike, and I'll show you guys how this thing kind of works. Can I like snag a sniped headshot here? It's gonna be difficult. Oh yeah. So why this thing is so good with Nisha is that reason. Basically, you get Garrett, like, you aim down sights, and it's basically guaranteed crits on that, like, or, you know, headshots. And look at the grouping on this thing, ready? Look how narrow that is. It, like, you can't even tell it's pellets. It almost looks like just, like, a sniper rifle or something. It, like, looks like one bullet, right? The grouping is so tight. What that means is it means that every single pellet goes into the enemy's head if you get that headshot, which Nisha just guarantees, so... I am pretty keen to make a shotgun build after a little while. After I like complete my pistol build, I'm probably going to make a guide for it and then make a shotgun build for the flanker. It'll be specifically designed for the flanker and to take advantage of that insane grouping, getting as much crit damage and stuff like that as possible as well. We got a Hyperion shotgun. That's pretty cool. I had something very similar to this before I found the flanker, and it was pretty damn good with Nisha, really, because even though the spread is much wider, you can still get... this is actually a plus crit damage one as well. That's actually a really good shotgun. Like, once you get those, like, unchained stacks up, and if you have a lot of attack speed, that's very similar to what I was using before this, and it was still really good. So, if you're making, like, a shotgun Nisha build, and maybe I'll give you guys a skill tree later, so you can, like, check that out, that's sort of the shotgun you're looking for, really, especially at endgame. Alright, so, I don't know how the flag is going to go against this guy, though, because we can't get headshots, at least on this first phase. Yeah, the damage is really low on that first phase. I mean, I can work him down after a couple of loads. There we go. If we can get the crits though, it might actually be pretty fast against the second phase. I don't think anything's going to be as fast as the laser. Oops. But we might actually still be able to do pretty well if I can get those crits. So this thing is also a Jacob, so it can fire. It fires as fast as you pull the trigger, and I'm getting wrecked. So. You can set up a click macro, or you can just click very fast and put those shots out really quickly. I think maybe I shouldn't do it with this thing. I don't know. This is not so good for these runs. I think maybe I should stick with the more reliable laser or the pure brute force of the fragnums, especially since I'm not actually running the shotgun build yet. I might be getting a little bit ahead of myself. Well, goodbye, Cash. Man, that Oz gets very, very purple. Very, very purple. It doesn't really match my outfit very much. Might have to do a bit of a fashion change. Alright, let's finish him up with the fragnums. Alright, where are you, Belly? There we are. Go, fragnums! Oh, there's a grenade there. Oh, boy. We're okay. And finish him! I see the head! So many head drops! Oh man, alright, getting the laser back out. We can get a kill on one of these guys. Burn him down, and where are you, broski? There he is, let's get underneath him. If you get right underneath him, you like pretty much guaranteed those crits. Okay, what did we actually get here? We got some moonstone, Got the head drop again. It's not even worth picking up because it only sells for 10k. If it sold for like 30k or something, maybe I wouldn't mind so much. Because at least it would be good cash. But, oh man, nothing this run. Just a little bit of Moonstone. Alright, let's finish this thing off. Oh, he healed me! That's my Oz kid just healed me and it made a little bloop sound when it did it. Wow, that was a full heal. That's pretty powerful, actually. I think this Oz kit was a good find. So we at least, even if we don't get the flaker, I'm pretty happy because we got that Oz kit. And man, I wasn't really holding my breath on getting a legendary Oz kit. I knew it was going to be quite a while until I got one. But we got pretty lucky, I think. I think that was pretty lucky, especially such a hard one to obtain as well. Let's see what we get on the Moonstone. We got more pistols. We got corrosive Malawans there. Yeah, no loon shining. We got 3% of shields on kill. It's not a bad loon shine. Less than 2 consumption on the scav. No really good bases or combos on those ones just there. Oh, and we're full again. So gonna have to empty out on the next run. I like to have a bit of fun with these guys every now and then because they're kind of unawares. Let's have a little bit of fun with the Excalibur. So, I missed. Wow. What a noob. There's the freeze. Let's go into melee. Go into melee. Quickly. There's the force wave, the shockwave. Where's the shockwave? Oh, wow. Excalibur, please. Come on. There we go. Shockwave? There it is. There's the shockwaves. That's the power of the Excalibur. Oh, yeah, that chain freezes. Ah, we had our fun. Back to work. Oh, man. Oh, man, that was a fail. I'm not doing well. I started off so well tonight. What's going on? My runs are getting progressively worse and worse. I'll start missing the treasure chests and stuff now. I did get the last treasure chest, though. I just, there's, like, nothing in them, so I just edited. I'll probably just edit it out. Alright, what do we get in here? So I like to use the time while that's opening to open these lockers. So efficient. Such efficiency. Wow, what? Another one? Oh my god, it costs so much. It's so expensive. Wow, okay. So this is the viral marketer. This is the new version of the conference call in the pre-sequel, which is a shotgun if you guys played Borderlands 2, you'll be pretty familiar with. Pretty popular shotgun. Oh man, that thing is almost 2 million? Alright, let me see what I can sell. I don't know if I'm going to be able to get 2 million cash together. Okay, yes, we just sell everything I don't need. Yep, we'll sell everything. Sell all this stuff, it's fine, I was going to keep that, but we'll sell it anyway, I need cash. Alright, 1.5, 1.6, 1.64. We're not going to get a flaker this run, but we're going to get like literally everything else. This is the other shotgun I was using. I've had this for ages, and it carried me really well. 47 even. Sell. keeping it. Wait, we're not keeping it. Alright, I was going to keep these shields, but screw it, we're selling them. We need the cash. Alright, 1.72. How long have we got? 17 minutes. Okay, if I kill Red and Belly, get their loot, like get all their loot, and then get the loot from all the chests as well, we should be able to afford it. Oh man, I hope so. I think if I leave the map, it'll like reset them as well. Not 100% sure on that, but we'll get it, guys. Don't worry. This is pretty exciting. I can't believe I got 2 legendaries in like half an hour in the vending machines. Wow. All right, here we go. And burn him. No, kill Belly. Kill Belly first, please. I'm more worried about Belly than Red. Red kind of just, like, flies around, derping into the walls and stuff. Half the time, he just, like, flies into a wall and doesn't do anything. Like, where is he now? Look at him. What are you even doing? He's not even doing anything. Let's burn him down. Get the crits! There we go. Now, we can kill a few of these little guys. I think they drop stuff as well. Alright, we've got to get everything we can. Sell, taking it to sell. Yep, I'm taking that to sell. We need all of it. Give us everything. Give us everything. Any money I like, buy this thing, and then there's like a perfect flacker in the next vendor, and I don't have any cash to buy it. And they're like, "There's no way of me making 2 million to get that." Man, he dropped a lot of moonstone that time. Huh? All right, I guess I'll sell the whites even. There's a bit of moonstone with that guy. Nice. Oh, I see something. I haven't actually got that. I haven't actually got that buggy yet. Wow, I can't believe I got one. There's one in here that I haven't gotten yet. I think that was everything in there. Let's go grab the chest. Punch the lock and get some more cash. Gimme, I need the cash. There might be some more cash in here. Gimme the cash, 390. Oh, still so far off. Come on, hurry up and open. Well, that's 17 minutes. I'm sure we're going to be okay. Wow, there could be cash in here. No, these are always have ammo, those ones. Moonstone, we can sell the stuff we get for cash. And there is... Oh, four pistols. Ooh, TD Or pistol, Jacobs. A Vladoff with bonus XP at level 50. Wow, that's so useless. Bonus XP when we don't need any more XP. Great. Awesome. Thank you. That's fantastic. That's actually a really good pistol, though. I'll take that. But we're going to be selling it. We're selling all things. We're taking no actual gear from this because we need to buy that legendary. All right. 1.739. I think we can make it, guys. I think if I grab this, go back and sell it. Let's not save an exit. Let's make sure I don't do that. All right. We got some sniper. Oh, I don't know. It's actually going to be pretty close. Let's check it out. Let's see what we get. All right. Back down here. Okay, okay. So this is a level 49 one, but because I don't have one, I still really want it. Let's try and sell some stuff here. Come on. 1.8, 1.85, 1.87, 1.9, 1.92, 1.95. Oh no. Oh no. Okay. Well, I don't want to sell any of those things. I can't sell the Pokeball. I don't want to sell the legendary shield we've got. What can I do to get some more loot? Alright, maybe we can go out here and kill some stuff. Wow, I only need, like, 30k more. Alright, we can do that. We can do that. I'm sure if I come out here and kill some stuff, we'll get it. So close, guys. I mean, normally this is the point where I'd be leaving the run and starting a new run, and it would be very profitable, but we need to, like, scrounge as much as we can right now. Where are all the spawns? Nothing is spawning. I guess we'll raid some safes for 300 cash. That's not exactly going to get us there in a hurry. Okay. Here we go. They're spawning. All right, if I get some drops off these guys. I'm here. My shield's talking to me. It's making sounds. What is it doing? Oh, it's probably dropping things when I'm killing these guys, I guess. Little boosters or something. Do I have to actually, like, activate them or something? No, that's not it. That's just ammo. You guys, you gotta drop some loot. Look, a little tiny pile of $1? Wow. Wow, what a scumbag. Okay. I've never really explored around in the camp because I just do the boss runs. That's not gonna help us. Oh, there's a loot chest. Alright, that's good. That's good news. Oh, and it dropped a 41k purple? Alright, we're good. We're good, guys. That was pretty good. Jesus, red and belly are entertaining. Alright, I'll be right. Alright, that, if my math is correct, that should take us the rest of the way. Yes. Okay, yes, perfect, awesome. That's the rest of the way. Let's get the social viral marketer. There we go. Is it? We got a badass rank for it as well. Impulse shopper, 10 badass ranks. And that is for, I didn't actually say why. I guess just buying a lot of things that are worth a lot of money, I guess. Alright, let me switch the Excalibur set out for this thing. We'll put a star on that. Let's take an inspection here. We have the social viral marketer. 13, it's a very cool looking weapon, right? I love that, like, black and red, the green trim. That is so sweet. So we have, that stock looks uncomfortable though. We have 1326 times 5. Pretty respectable base damage, even for a level 49 weapon. And I mean, our flakker is 49 too, and that's pretty decent. 73 accuracy, fire rate 3.4, which is decent for a shotgun. I'm guessing it's an auto shotgun. It's Hyperion, so it should be, yeah. It's got 9 magazine size. It's a corrosive type fire marketer. I don't know if that's always the case or not. I'm not too familiar with this weapon besides that. Forward, lol, check this out, guys. And then it's got the negative weapon recoil reduction and weapon accuracy. Highly effective versus Accura armory, and fire increases accuracy like all Hyperion weapons. So I have, like, no idea, like, what this thing's real deal is, but That seems pretty legit as a more traditional style shotgun. The flaker is like kind of a unique style of weapon, like the way it's like got the very tight clustering, and it's kind of meant for shotgun sniping. It's almost like using a slug to, you know, headshot something with. This is a much more traditional auto style shotgun, and I'm imagining this thing is going to absolutely wreck, you know, machines and stuff. So we start, the accuracy starts off there, and then it starts to getting really, really accurate after a few shots. So what you just saw there was like the really fast attack speed was after I reload, sometimes I have a chance to fire twice, it procced a few times in a row. Well, so far this has been, I don't know about profitable, but I would say reasonably successful. Let's do a few more runs. Alright, so I know this thing's corrosive and not really good against fleshy targets, but I kind of want to give it a bit of a whirl anyway to see how it goes. Damn, that double firing is insane. Well, it was pretty effective. But I think it's just a decent weapon anyway, and against like just those sorts of guys. I think it's really going to shine against those like armored targets though. If you're fighting, it could be pretty good against RK5 if I can get those crits on the front of it when it swoops down low when it goes for its bombing runs. Could be interesting for some RK5 farming runs. But nice to have. I'm building up my collection. Not exactly the way I was predicting building it up. Because I hadn't ever gotten a legendary from those vending machines before, and then I get two in one night, but there you go, legendaries are legendaries. Now I gotta like manually aim. Oh man, after getting used to Anisha's aimbot, you get like manual aiming feels so like weak. I guess I have some understanding of why people like to use aimbots in FPS games now. Because you feel so powerful. But no, guys, I'm kidding. Don't use aimbots in multiplayer FPSs, guys. It's not cool. If you're gonna use an aimbot, use Nisha instead. Get your aimbotting tendencies out on Nisha. It's so much more fun and is endorsed. This has been a ZiggyD public service announcement. I'm getting a lot of pistols. Jacobs, TDR, no good bases though. No like Vladoff or Hyperion with really good rolls. Oh man. How did I screw that up? How even? Man, that Oz kit heals are really, really powerful. I just went down to zero shield and almost died, and then full shield heal. That's like awesome, because I get a full shield heal from using Showdown, 100% from one of my skills. And then to get a full shield heal again, just like randomly after that, that's super powerful. Yeah, take out Red first, and then we'll actually kill Billy afterwards. I think that'll be more fun, because then we can see what he drops. I'll switch to the Fragments here and finish him off. Get a few crits of the Fragments. Oh, I'm gonna get burnt down here. We can finish him! We can finish him! Where'd he go? What the? Come back here. We can get him! We can get him! Hold still, bro. Hold still. There we go. I see two Moonstone and a green weapon. Nothing too exciting. Next Moonstone. I'm running low on Moonstone. Not many left. Maybe one or two left. Ooh, a purple rocket launcher. Check it out, 72k for one. That's nice. I actually have a rocket launcher at the moment. I don't have any rocket launchers. Maybe I should, like, you know, take one. And maybe, like, keep it or something until I find a better one. I don't know about using a shock rocket launcher. It doesn't seem too helpful to me. I think I'd probably prefer just a plain old explosive one, I think. Like, I think I'd prefer non-elemental shotgun, rocket launcher, sorry, because then I can use it against virtually anything, whereas if it's like shock, it's only going to be good against shields, and some things will be resistant to it. Yeah, I don't know. I think I'd prefer a non-elemental one. I wonder if it's faster to run under here and kind of just like side scoot like that. It doesn't slow you down if you kind of like side scoot. Might be faster than running, like sort of jumping over the top. It'd be interesting to know whether it's faster to like jump everywhere or just run everywhere. That'll be something like the professional speedrunners will work out. Alright, Billy, it's your turn. Oh, yes! Burnt him down in a real hurry there. What do we get? Dropped a blue SMG. And just some other randoms. Nothing too exciting there. Oh, we dropped a fair bit of Moonstone, though. And looks like Red dropped a little bit of Moonstone, too. I think he's like Red's like spread his loot all over the place. I don't even know. I see a little bit more down there. He dropped it all down here as well. Oh, second last Moonstone. Oh, purple. Alright, we just got a legendary one. I think we're all set for Oz kits for now. Oh, that was almost so good. That was so quick. I didn't even like take the time to run up, but I overshot the lamp. I don't think I've ever done that. Ever overshot that lamp. And then I like didn't do the sign properly either. Well, it was gonna be glorious. I thought it would be a glorious final run. But I guess it was not to be. And here we go for the final kill. Let's take out Red first. Red got absolutely wrecked. Now where's Billy? There he is. And he's going down too. Oh, I didn't quite get it in the, There we go, we're gonna shoot him from above there. Awesome. And he dropped the head for the last one. Of course. As if to taunt me, the head sits there, staring blankly up at me. Going, no legendary for you tonight. Although, the vending machine's certainly paid out. Let's go grab the Moonstone chest and we'll finish up there. Since it's my last, I literally have 42 Moonstone left, so I'll be down to two last Moonstone. Oh, there's a white pistol in there, I guess. I guess I'll take that. And anything from the last treasure chest here? I'm not going to bother going up to the top one. Let's take the last Moonstone chest down to two Moonstone. We kind of bankrupt ourselves, and it's grenades. Bum, bum, bum. Okay, let us save and quit, and then check out how we finished up for this evening of farming. Okay, so I would say that in terms of like cash and Moonstone, we didn't really make a profit this run. We started with 1 million and we now have 600,000 left, so we actually kind of made a loss there. And we started with like, I don't know, 300-400 Moonstone and we're down to 2. But that doesn't mean it was a loss, because we did indeed find ourselves the Social Viral Marketer shotgun. A cool corrosive shotgun that looks pretty swacky, but I have yet to sort of learn everything about this thing. Maybe there's some hidden stuff I don't know about yet. I don't know what that forward, forward, forward thing does. Red text usually has some extra thing associated with it. But I'm very happy with this new Oz kit we found, 3DD1. I think that was the real star of this evening. Speaking of, let's star it. Since it's got a star, I give you a gold star. Beep, boop, beep. 3DD1, very hard Oz kit to obtain. And it seems pretty damn strong. Like, it actually gives us additional shield capacity. Whoa, I didn't even notice that. Wow, and laser damage, that's like perfect for me. Wow, and air control. Wow, this thing's insane. That was a really good find. So, I think overall, guys, I think we did pretty damn well. What do you guys think? So, no striker for us. No striker. But, we still got the other one. But, I'll continue farming some red and belly in the future, and maybe I'll get myself a level 51 so I can make a build around it. But anyway, guys, hopefully you enjoyed this another 40 minute or so boss farming video. If you guys have a suggestion of a boss farming run you'd like to see for the next one, then do let me know in the comments below. Anyway, that's it for now. I'm ZiggyD, and thanks for watching.